You're watching ZoomFest 2020, a Goodly Frame Theater production inspired by theater creatives and dedicated to sharing stories in a new way, because all the world's a stage. Welcome to episode 2. Our stories today are Eliza 2020 by Mike Brannon, Love No Matter What by Shelley Stolaroff-Segal, and Marriage Matters by Clinton Festa.
Is this damn thing working? Hello? Hello, Rachel?
I don't think she's here yet, Saul.
We see her in her own little window.
Why the hell isn't she here? It's Tuesday at 6 o'clock. She's supposed to call us every Tuesday at 6 o'clock. You know this, Sarah. You know the routine.
I'm sure there's a million reasons why she could be running late. She's got the kids to take care of, not to mention her very important job working at the internet programming company.
Oh boy, here we go.
My daughter, an internet programmer. When I was her age, it was hard enough getting into the secretarial pool. Now she's writing software programs that get used all over the world.
She knows how to program a computer, but apparently not how to look at a damn wristwatch.
Saul.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. It's so good to see you both.
Rachel, it's so nice to see you.
Where are my grandkids? How come I never can see my grandkids?
You're asking about your grandkids. Dad, you know that it's after midnight here in Stockholm. The kids are fast asleep. And besides, I'm sure you can keep up with their activities on social media.
Oh, yes. I saw that Eliza went to the Natural Science Museum on a field trip the other day. What did she think of the butterflies?
Why are you asking about butterflies?
What? Well, you always used to love chasing butterflies when you were younger. You'd catch them in paper bags and then let them crawl around on your hands and arms before letting them fly off into the sky.
I'm not sure I understand. Why are you asking about butterflies?
It's not important, Rachel. Don't mind your mother. She's getting increasingly sentimental in her old age. So tell me about your job, sweetheart. How are things going?
Things are going great. I'm up for a promotion next month, and everyone is really happy with my work on the new neural network simulator.
The new neural network simulator. What's that about? Sounds like something out of a science fiction movie.
Did you get that recipe for pound cake I sent you?
Oh, yes. I got the recipe, and I made a beautiful pound cake with fresh raspberries just the other day.
Oh, good. I was worried you wouldn't be able to find the ingredients. Do they have Crisco in Sweden?
I'm not sure I understand what you mean.
Crisco. You know, Crisco. It comes in a blue can.
I'm not sure I understand what you mean.
You just said that. Rachel, are you feeling okay?
I'm not sure I understand what you mean. I'm not sure I understand what you mean.
Rachel, what's wrong?
What the devil is wrong with you?
What's going on?
I'm not sure I understand what you mean. I'm not sure I understand what you mean. I'm not sure I understand.
What was that? I don't understand. Was the video program glitching?
Program glitching, glitching the code maybe. Maybe. You remember, Sarah, when I brought home our first computer, Commodore 64 from the office had a keyboard and these AV cables so we could hook it up to the TV?
Oh, yes. She loved that computer. She took to it like a fish to water.
And Rachel wrote this one game in BASIC. Do you remember where you'd pretend you were talking to a psychologist? And it would ask questions, only there was no real person on the other end, just a bunch of switch statements and code for natural language processing.
I do remember that. It was called Eliza. You wrote that together. And then you tricked me by saying I was talking to a real person.
That's what this is. That screen, the way Rachel was acting, She made a simulation that could chat with us in real time. Oh. Rachel Weisenbaum, I know you're there. You had better talk to your parents.
There you are. What on earth are you doing?
Mom, Dad, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have used the neural net software on you guys.
You think we're stupid, Rachel? You think we wouldn't notice you'd swapped in some digital copy?
No, Dad, of course not.
So, you're not being fair with Rachel.
Not being fair? We're asking too much that our only daughter should call us once a week?
Oh, that's all. That's the only thing you're asking for.
Rachel, please.
What else should I want?
I'm sorry, Dad. I'm sorry I don't always have time. The first time I used the simulator...
Whoa, the first time? You mean you've used this before? We've been talking to some hologram thinking it was our real daughter?
It was right in the middle of the Stockholm move. The office was in uproar. I had 3 reports due the next day. The kids were sick with the flu.
Rachel, it's all right. We understand.
Well, how can you say you understand?
You don't know what it's like trying to raise children on your own.
On your own? It's easy to be a parent when you can stay at home and see them every day. I'll tell you this, even when I was busy, work piled high, I still never missed a teacher conference, never missed a recital.
Yes, Dad, you set quite the standard.
Well, what's that supposed to mean?
It means that the simulated Rachel was better for you than the real thing. The other Rachel had time to talk with you and bake pound cakes and tell you perfect stories about her perfect life. The real Rachel, some nights she can't even find the time to microwave a lasagna.
Rachel, sweetie, we understand.
Maybe you understand, Sarah. Me? I can always find time for my family.
I'm sorry, Mom. I tried keeping up appearances, but...
Rachel Weisenbaum, you listen to me. Your father and I were very proud of you, of the work you've done, of who you've become. We don't expect you to be perfect, to have everything put together. If your week gets busy, if you can't call, for your parents, we'll understand.
I know you will, Mom. But Dad?
No, I know. I'll talk to him. I'll bake him a pound cake.
I love you, Mom. Tell Dad I love him, too.
My dearest Rachel, I love you more than the world.
Rachel?
Hey, Mom, so they said I can come in after all, and as long as I work from 7 to 3, then I should be able to leave early. So I think I decided to fly, which would put me there around 8 or 9. I mean, that's
Megan,
not many.
Megan, I cannot believe that you called me a Karen the other day. I looked it up on Urban Dictionary, and I don't think that I deserve that.
What? Mom, I was just kidding. I mean, I didn't mean
No, you weren't. I mean, are you really okay with them leaving the cookies out, uncovered, and the lemon bars? Anyone could just walk by. Can you imagine the germs It's not that hard to put everything behind little loose sight doors.
Mom, you weren't even talking to the right person. You had me on speaker, remember?
I mean, you were anyone could come along and cough or sneeze or drool on them.
Okay, I get it. And yes, I agree, Mom, but I mean, you can't just go.
I feel like you criticize everything that I say or do for sport.
For sport? I mean, who talks like that?
See what I mean?
When did you get so sensitive? Jesus, you act like this all the time now. You know, you'll live longer if you don't take yourself so seriously.
Really, Megan? You're going to lecture me with your vast 23 years of experience. If I wanted condescension, I would go speak to your father.
Okay, Mom, you're proving my point.
It just sometimes I feel like you're examining me, like I'm in some sort of petri dish.
No, Mom, Zach and I are from a petri dish. Anyway, you're the one that's always examining me.
Megan, that's my job.
Look, can we change the subject? I don't have a lot of time, and I just want to know when you want us to come in and...
Us! Who is us? Who are you bringing? Oh, God! Stop. What's his name, is it? You're not still seeing him, are you? Megan, he's too old for you.
Robert? His name is Robert, Mom, and no, I'm not bringing him. I mean, do you think I'm a complete idiot?
That's good. So who are you bringing?
I mean, what you did to Sander was so cringy and inappropriate.
What are you even talking about? I was nice to him. I let him shower here when he needed to. I bought him new socks and guitar strings.
Mom, you kept nagging him about college. I mean, I told you that they have till they're like 25 to go. And
you're never too young to go to college, Megan. Look at your dad. Besides, I didn't even think that I was being...
embarrassing? Well, you'll be happy to know that he took his exams this year.
Oh, so you're still keeping up with him?
Really, Mom? Yes, we're close. We still chat. I mean, you didn't shut it all down, you know?
For the 800th time, I'm sorry. Anyway, if you're not bringing what's-his-face, then who are you bringing?
I'm bringing my cat.
My cat? Oh, I didn't know that you got a cat. That's wonderful. You're going to love the company.
Yeah, I just got her. She's so cute. I mean, she's just a kitten. I think she's like a calico or something. You're going to love her. She's a rescue.
Oh, good for you. What did you name her?
Kitty.
Kitty.
Yeah, I'm keeping it simple.
And what about her litter box? Who's going to take care of that when you're here?
I'm going to clean her litter box, Mom.
I'm only asking because remember that time when...
Yes, I remember, but that was years ago. And plus, she doesn't really poop that much. It's mainly just a lot.
Where are you going to put her litter box? What if she decides to go into Daphne and Delilah's?
I don't know, Mom. I mean, Daphne and Delilah don't mind sharing a box.
Okay, well, I'll go and get two more, just to be safe.
Kittens or boxes?
Aha, good show. Megan, I am so glad you're coming here. It wouldn't be the same without you. And your brother, he's going to be thrilled when you walk through that door.
I'll be thrilled too, Mom. I miss him. How's his speech this week? I mean, did you print out those worksheets that I sent?
Yes, I printed out the worksheets, and he loved them. I could tell.
Oh, that's good. Oh, Mom, quick question. Are there going to be place cards or anything?
Well, I'm not sure yet, honey. I don't think it's really that formal. It's in the afternoon.
Oh, okay. Well, could you make sure Aunt Mimi sits with you and Dad or something?
Do you have a problem with your grandmother?
No, of course not. I just want to sit with Zach, and I don't feel like talking about politics. I mean, she always wants me to convert. Do you remember last time when she just kept...
When you tried to give your grandmother a stroke. Yes, I remember that.
I didn't. I just wanted to show her the difference between...
Honey, I can't help it if she's going to want to talk to you.
Okay, well, you better have enough wine around.
You know that's not going to be a problem.
Maybe she can talk to Aunt Connie or something.
Maybe I can get muzzles for each of them and have them sit at the other end of the table.
God, I can't believe you two share the same DNA. I mean, what happened to her?
The same thing that happened to me. We got older and wiser.
Wiser? Really? I mean, I still can't get over the fact that you're a moderate.
As if that were such a bad thing.
Well, it is, and you know it is. I mean, you raised me to be a critical thinker.
Critical does not mean radical. You know what? Let's not get into this again. It makes my blood pressure go up, and yours too, only you're younger and you can take it.
All right. What should I wear?
Something pretty, with sleeves.
Right. Isn't it gonna be hot there?
I guess you could go sleeveless and wear a light shawl or something.
Mom.
Seriously, you know how they run the air conditioning. It's always freezing inside.
I'm not covering up my tattoos.
What? Who said anything about tattoos?
Seriously, I do not care.
Megan, do you know what I just heard last week? They have this incredible new cream on the market. It's completely waterproof and totally easy. It doesn't turn orange or smudge or
anything. Mom.
Right. It was worth a try. But Megan, you have such beautiful skin.
Okay. Thanks, Mom. Look, before I forget, I just wanted to tell you that Devin is picking me up from the airport.
Aw, that's so sweet of him. How's he doing?
Mom, she's fine. Please, it's so annoying when you do that.
When I do what?
Really? Look, just please make sure not to be at the house when we get there.
Megan, that's hurtful.
Seriously, you embarrassed me last time.
Well, I told you that I was sorry. I didn't do it on purpose. It's just that she looks so much like the he that you grew up with.
Okay, whatever. Look, Mom, I really have to go. I only have like 10 minutes to eat.
Well, I'm glad that we had a chance to talk. It's been a while.
Mom, you called me on Monday.
I know, but I miss you.
I know, I miss you too.
Really? You miss your old mother?
Really, Mom, you're not old. Stop fishing for a compliment or something, I mean.
And speaking of fish, there's a new vegetarian restaurant that opened up downtown. You're going to love it. I checked out the menu for you.
Okay, well, just so you remember, I don't eat fish.
Yes, yes, I know, honey. And I'll make sure that you get the lentil and mushroom meatballs.
Really have to go now. I'm running late. Can you just tell Dad and Zach that hi for me and that I miss them?
Maggie, I forgot to tell you about your father, didn't I?
Tell me what?
I did forget. Oh my goodness. Are you sitting down?
Yes, Mom. I'm sitting down. We're on a Zoom and I guess I won't have time to eat.
Oh, Megan, this is worth it and you can eat one of those meals that I ship to you.
Mom, you send me steaks.
Oh, I forgot.
Ugh. Anyway, it's fine. I gave them to my landlord.
You gave them to your landlord?
Yes, Mom. Don't worry about it. He's a really nice guy.
Megan, those steaks were expensive, and he might expect, you know, something in return.
Ew, Mom, seriously? That's so gross. He's like 90. And plus, now that I think about it, he probably can't even eat them. He's, like, missing most of his teeth.
Wonderful. He's missing his teeth. Megan, where do you live? In a trailer park?
Oh, my God. No, Mom. I told you I moved into a duplex.
A duplex. Right. I forgot. I really should visit, you know. I can't believe you haven't invited me yet. It's insulting.
Mom, I told you it's not your style. I mean, You wouldn't really...
Megan, what you're telling me is that it's in a crappy neighborhood.
No. It's not crappy. It's not in an area that you would especially appreciate.
It's crappy. Megan, why don't you let me come and fix up your place? I bet you don't have any curtains up, do you? You probably got those plastic blinds, and do you even have an area rug? You know, I could come out and I could bring something for you. And
what were you going to tell me about Dad?
What?
My father. You wanted me to sit down and everything.
Oh, right. Oh, gosh, it's so exciting. But do you know what? Let's just chat about it when you're here for the luncheon. Because, you know, then everybody will be sitting down.
Seriously? Okay, whatever. I'm late now. I gotta hop, Mom, okay?
Okay, baby. Look, I love you so much. Call me if Devin can't come get you. And don't forget to bring a sweater. Oh, and by the way, daughter, I am technically too old to be a Karen. So please don't forget that when you come.
Okay, Boomer.
Megan.
Love you, Mom.
Hello, Josie. Hello, Zach. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too, Dr. Steve.
So how's the marriage counseling business lately? Is it slow because everybody's stuck in quarantine together?
You kidding? It's been a gold mine. So anyway, congratulations on the engagement. Have y'all picked out a wedding date yet?
No, not yet. We were thinking maybe 3 summers from now. I'll have my master's done, we'll have both cars paid off, and there's a really long waiting list at the gardens where I want to do the ceremony.
That's so annoying.
I know, but it's a beautiful garden, so it's worth the wait.
No, that's not what I meant. I mean the fact that you're going to wait 3 summers for the whole universe to line up for your stupid wedding. That's just one of my pet peeves.
I'm sorry?
If you really want to get married, you wouldn't wait so long.
Okay. Well, thanks for your honest opinion, doctor.
Aren't you supposed to be a marriage counselor? Why are you being so rude to my fiance?
Exactly. I'm here to give you premarital advice. Let me tell you, the wedding is just the first day of your marriage. The focus should be on the marriage, not the wedding.
Okay, well, that's what we're here for. We want to do everything we can to have a good, strong marriage.
That's what you're gonna get, but no, that's not what you're here for. Your father called Josie. He told me that the only reason that you two are doing this today is because he's refusing to pay for the wedding if you don't.
Busted.
And he said you should get my professional recommendation as well. But I think that's a great idea. I wish I would have had premarital counseling.
Oh, have you been married, doctor?
Yeah, plenty of times.
Oh, what happened?
Let me put it to you this way, Zach. As a husband, you're gonna have to pick. Now, you can either be right or you can be married. And I'm always right, so I'm seldom married. But enough about me. Do either one of you know what causes most relationships to go bad?
Bad communication?
I feel like it's a lack of respect.
No, oh no. It's all about the pet peeves. You see, in every relationship that fails, The warning signs were there from the beginning.
Hence the phrase, arguing like an old married couple?
Yes, or the old adage, the police found the decapitated head in the backyard. You see, with time, all pet peeves just get worse, and we all get sick of tolerating them. So, we're going to do an exercise that I call pet peeve analysis to find out what really ticks you off. Are you ready?
Sure, but I don't have any pet peeves.
And neither do I, and nothing Josie does irritates me.
Right. Anyone can say nothing bothers them, but it's another thing when something's actually happening and you can't stop it.
Uh-oh. So this is why you told us to skip lunch today?
That's right. We want you nice and grumpy.
Honey, don't mess this up. You're always messing things up.
And we have our first one. Guys, I just want you to let loose, okay? It's all about honesty. And it's okay to have pet peeves. We just want to know what they are so that the other person doesn't trigger them.
Okay.
Yes, doctor.
So we're going to set up a few scenarios. Now I need to tell you, some of these are going to be very convincing. Our first scenario is a common one. Somebody doesn't know the words to a song, but they sing along anyway.
Uh-oh. I do that sometimes.
That's okay. I think it's cute.
That should be no problem. Okay, here's our scenario. You're out at a bar together. It's St. Patrick's Day, and Josie's drunk. Josie, sing me, please, Danny Boy.
But I don't know the words.
Perfect. Sing.
Oh, Donny Boy, our call.
Okay, please just stop. Please. Please just stop.
The gardens, Zach.
Yes, dear.
Okay, for our next scenario.
Doctor, just for the record, I feel like it's pronounced scenario.
Okay. Scenario it is. You know what? I think my pen's running out of ink.
Uh-oh. Already?
Yeah, still got a little ink left. Gosh, this is a tough one. Do I throw out the pen or put it back with the others?
Oh, well, obviously you should. This is a trap, isn't it?
Yes, Zach. But the question is, what?
Yes, what? I feel like... I'm feeling like...
Do you even hear yourself?
What are you talking about?
Do you have to say, I feel like, before everything you say? You sound like such a wimp!
No, I don't! Josie, I feel like...
There it is! You should get a big tattoo on your forehead saying, I would lose to you in a fight! Punch here!
Well, at least I don't post everything about my life on social media.
What are you talking about?
Hey guys, look, it's me and my coworkers at eating breadsticks at the Olive Garden. Isn't my life so great? Nobody cares. Nobody cares.
Look, Zach, in 3 summers from now, I'm getting married at Sarah P. Duke Gardens. And it doesn't have to be to you.
Shall I call your father?
No! We can do this!
Yes, we can. Just remember that mantelpiece decoration we saw at Target, sweetie.
You're right. You're right! Doctor, we can do this. You want to know how I know we can do this?
How?
Well, the other day we were putting items on our registry at Target.
For your wedding 3 years from now?
No, for our engagement party next month.
Of course.
Anyway, we both saw the same decoration. And at that moment, we knew we were meant to be together. It said, love is patient, love is kind.
Dot, dot, dot.
From 1 Corinthians.
No, I told you it was from Target. We just saw it. Love is patient, love is kind.
Dot, dot, dot. Dot.
Right. From 1 Corinthians chapter 13.
No, from Target, aisle 9.
Well, that's great. Patience and kindness matter. The problem is your fiance has the patience of a sperm cell and you have the kindness of a botched vasectomy.
So we're a perfect match.
No.
That's right, honey. And not only are we getting married, but we're getting the decoration from Target.
That's great. Buy a whole bunch, put them one in every room. But don't kid yourselves. This hasn't gone well today. The fact is, you haven't successfully completed marriage counseling. I don't think you ever will. I just can't recommend.
And if you fail us, or call her dad and tell him that you think that we shouldn't be married, well then all that means is we don't get the big fancy wedding.
That's right, and that's fine. We'll still get married, even if it's not at the gardens. We're not perfect, we know that. But we love each other.
We'll figure it out. Because love is patient. And love is kind. Dot, dot, dot.
Remember when I told you today that some of these scenarios were going to be very convincing?
Yeah. So?
Wait. Does that mean you were pretending to fail us?
That's correct. You two are going to get on each other's nerves. That's a given. But you two stuck together just now, in the face of outside doubt and adversity. I'm impressed. You even cared and learned to care more about each other than having the perfect wedding day. But now don't get too excited. You still have some things to work on.
Same time next week, Doctor?
I'll put you down on my calendar. Now, before we go, give yourselves a round of applause.
Is that how you clap? Well, at least I don't sing song the end of my sentences, which, by the way, is really annoying.
Oh, really? Does it literally make your head explode? Does it literally make your ears bleed?
You chew like a llama.
You smell like a llama.
You two still getting married?
Yes!
And they lived happily ever after. Dot, dot, dot.
On my shoulder.
If you enjoyed this episode, be sure to subscribe so you'll be notified when the next episode is posted. Goodly Frame Theater, based in Greensboro, North Carolina, can be found on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and of course at goodlyframe.org.